Imagine sitting down and spending just 10 to 15 minutes in a deep state of communication with the universe. In these moments, you're able to perfectly craft how your life looks and feels in every way. The energy you create is huge, beautiful, and feels like it radiates from your very inner being. This emotion, this energy, moves like a sculptor's hands into all the situations around you, modifying, adjusting, and shaping. Well, this energy is a flow dream, and it's an activation that works. We're going to talk about how to use a flow dream, how to do your own, and how to make your life wishes come true. Stay with me. Flow dreaming, still kinda woo-woo, is just what it sounds like. An escape into the world of woo. Also, a ride into you. And how to feel happier, wiser, and more self-aware in every way. It's your ultimate journey into personal growth and inner power. We'll explore ideas like how your energy self influences the kinds of opportunities you encounter, or how your personal growth can drive your business growth. Or even how that feeling of being stuck is really always coming from something else. We just have to figure out what. That's right, we're a dash of woo-woo, a sprinkle of self-care, a heap of problem-solving and pattern-busting, and a giant cup of encouragement. We're going to relight so much passion, purpose, self-love, and confidence in you that you practically stagger. I'm Summer McStravick, your host, and welcome to Flowdreaming, still kinda woo-woo. That's right, today we're gonna dive into what is the nature of a flow dream? Why is this not a meditation? What do you mean by energy activation? Well, we're gonna look into all of that. And I'm going to share one with you, one that's called instant alignment. We'll do it together so you can have a 5-minute experience of this really, really powerful practice. So backing up a little, my name is Summer McStravick, as you probably heard in the intro. And if this is one of your first times listening, you might wonder, well, who are you? What is this thing? I'm going to preface our entire episode today by saying I have been teaching flow dreaming since 2005, practicing since the year 2000. My past includes a 10-year stint working in corporate publishing for, of all people, Louise L. Hay. Yes, she was my boss at Hay House, and that is where I got to spend a decade really honing and figuring out how do I share flow dreaming with the world. Well, I was blessed that Hay House published several of my own books, and instead of being an employee, I went out and became my author, a teacher, which I guess was the whole point of skilling me up there in the first place. Dr. Wayne Dyer, my co-host for 5 years, actually, was integral to me being able to really get this message out. So again, I think I got my MBA in spirituality from the 10 years that I poured into creating Hay House Radio and the podcast and everything that you kind of experience today or used to experience back then, but where it's all evolved to. That said, that's a little bit of my background, so you know a bit who I am. Flow dreaming is a modality that arrived in my life exactly when I needed it. I was asking to go big, to find my purpose, to have something that I could become very successful at. And flow dreaming said, I have something for you. It's called flow dreaming. You are suited, perfectly suited for sharing this technique, this philosophy with the world. So I've been striving to keep up with it ever since. Now, flow dreaming is also unique and different because it's not really meditation. It's not meditation at all, actually. But it helps to describe it that way sometimes because meditation, well, we all know what it is, and many of us have practiced it or do practice it. And we know that it creates beautiful benefits in our life. It reshapes our neural networks and forms new pathways. works to enhance the neuroplasticity of our brains and generally calms us and centers us and helps us get through life. Well, Flowdreaming actually does all of those same things, but it's got a few extras. I use Flowdreaming principally for manifesting, co-creating, showing the universe this is who I am, this is who we're where we're going, and this is what I'm looking forward to experiencing. I use Flowdreaming to craft, to, like I said, sculpt the being that is me. I don't wait for the outside world to hand me opportunities for my growth. I say instead to the outside world, this is the kind of growth I'm seeking. Here is how I want to feel, what I want to experience, what I want to become. Now, I have done some really good introductory episodes on what Flowdreaming is. In fact, episode number 650, 650 is a great introduction if you can dig that one out of the archives. I also have a YouTube channel where I've recorded a complete tutorial called Ignite Your Manifesting Power. And I share with you exactly how to do the practice of Flowdreaming as well as some of the philosophy behind it. But that's not my intention today. Today, I just want to get you into flow. I want you to feel this experience. And I want to clarify what I consider an energy activation to be. So there's a lot of talk out there, especially with people who use crystals and certain forms of Reiki and energy work about energy activations. And it dawned on me not too long ago, took me a while, a couple decades to figure it out, but it dawned on me that essentially when you move into flow, you are engaging in an energy activation. Now, this came about when I was exploring the world of Wicca and very ancient paganistic natural practices. I was leaning in a bit more and trying to kind of go back to some of my old roots. And one of the things that I discovered or re-remembered is that they call, quote, witches all kinds of different types. There's hedge witches and moon witches and fire witches and energy witches. And I thought, energy witch, what does that mean? What does that mean? And I thought, well, it's someone who creates magic, who performs a transformation inside themselves or perhaps even externally, using the power of energy. Now, my sciency brain pops right in and says, hey, wait a second. When you flow dream, you're actually affecting quantum space. That's all you're doing. You're just talking to the fabric of information that forms all things. Basic atoms and molecules and quantum data, right? All strung together. Kind of like the double helix is strung together into your DNA and RNA. Everything in our life is brought together with quantum energy, which is really just information. When you flow dream, you are going to the level of that information, sort of broadening your emotional, mental, energetic space to be able to have a richer conversation with it. Instead of just saying, there's some invisible stuff out there and I don't know how it works and how the whole life of mine gets put together and I have no idea how events and situations and synchronicities and coincidences come about in my life. Well, who says that anymore? But it's an old way of thinking. I know plenty of people who still think that way. But when we flow dream, what we're saying is, hold on, wait a second. I am an integral part of sharing this informational state with life. Life doesn't happen to me. The outside world just doesn't throw things in and see what sticks. It's not just random chaos. In fact, most things in my life are pretty ordered and pretty predictable. There must be some sort of game plan here, some sort of something that all this is running on that makes sense and has rules. And similarly, if I point myself in a certain direction, I notice life often starts to support me, especially if I feel very aligned, very responsive, very excited, very passionate. I'll start to get a kind of vibrancy around this. I'll get opportunities. I'll get ways of going deeper. Whereas if I point myself in a direction I don't want to go in, that I'm forcing myself to do, that I have to do, that I hate, I tend to find a lot of hardship there. I tend to find things are slow and resistant, and I've got to hammer away and plug away in it. And I can tell, because even though there's something in my mind saying, should, you have to do this, this is it, there's another part of me that says, oh, I don't want to, this is so hard. All this is you interacting with the space in front of you, the time in front of you, the flow of events, of people, of opportunities that are already seeking and seeping into your future, coming together in these perfect little moments, rolling towards you like little glass marbles. When we flow dream, we are opening a conduit of communication with our current selves and with our future self, the self that's in the making right now. So when you hear me do a flow dream, and we're going to do one shortly together, what you're actually hearing is me leading you into an energetic, emotional state of being where I am calling to you, I am tugging on you, and I'm saying, feel this with me, open to this with me, dive in, be expansive with me. Now, I do this because, well, I love it. And it turns out that it's kind of part of who I am. And apparently my life's purpose to spread this word that you can do this too. Now, flow dreaming, kind of like meditation, is something you can do all by yourself. You just sit down, you close your eyes, and you go in. But a lot of us really like guided meditations where we have a teacher or a guide in our ears leading us. Feel this, do this. It relieves the pressure, it simplifies it, it allows us to oftentimes go deeper because somebody else is doing the heavy lifting of telling us what to see or think or feel. Flowdreaming is just the same. You can do it by yourself, or you can do it with a guide like me. That's why at flowdreaming.com, yes, blatant plug for my shop, I have over 300 guided flow dreams, recorded audios that you can drop right into that will energetically start changing and shifting your life and yourself. So if you're looking to do, gosh, just about anything, maybe you want to get fully happy and completely loving toward your body. I've got a flow dream for that. Maybe you want to lose some weight or feel fit. I've got a flow dream for that. Maybe you're looking for a new home. I've got a flow dream for that. Maybe you've got a situation that you need to turn out right. It needs to go in your direction. It really needs to be successful. I've got a flow dream for that. Maybe you and your partner are having some issues with communication and openness and trying to catch up and be on the same page in your life together. I've got a flow dream that helps with that. Maybe you're ready to shift into a higher gear in your income, in your work, in your career. I've got a zillion flow dreams for that. So I'm just kind of painting a picture. Not to say, hey, I've got all these flow dreams, which I do, that's partly it, but to also reveal to you and get you thinking all these things that you want to change or shift or grow or correct in your life, you can start doing it. Don't wait for the outside world to give you situations that force the change, that cause you to say, oh, now I can do this. With flow dreaming, we tell our lives, our future selves first. This is where I want to work. This is where I want to grow. This is where I want to experience ease and fulfillment now, like now. That is the point of an energy activation. It's an active process. It's full of emotion. It should make you feel something. And when I lead you in, you're going to notice, well, three simple pieces to the process. The one we're going to do in a few minutes is called instant alignment. And when you go in, three things will happen. One, I'm going to ask you to open up your imagination. I'm going to say, see some things with me, imagine them. I call this a guided daydream. because it feels just like daydreaming in the beginning. Now, as you release into a daydream, something funky always happens, right? It's a characteristic of a daydream. We forget we're daydreaming. We are someplace else. We are kind of in two places at once. We just finished doing all the dishes. Wait a second. I don't remember doing the last dish, but I just put it away, so I must be done. I just drove home, but I don't remember. Here I am in my driveway, arriving at my front door. The characteristic is called being in flow. Flow is something that you will shift into automatically when you get into this state. Now, when you're there, something kind of special and magical happens. I call it getting behind the scenes of life, going from physical to non-physical. In fact, kind of opening a bullhorn from one to the other, or a nicer way of saying it is a conduit of communication. The same way your computer opens a conduit to all the other computers in the world, right? The email that I send you, I send it and you get it a second later, even if I'm in California and you're in London. That's like magic, isn't it? Yet there's real, rational, solid scientific methodology for why that happens. I want you to think of consciousness in a similar way. When you open the energy conduit, the communication portal, to something greater, which I call non-physical, the net of consciousness that we all are, I mean, if every computer in our world can be linked, every human mind is likewise linked. We humans, we just create replicas of ourselves. That's what AI is. We said, I want to have something that can think and compute, just like my own incredible brain, which, by the way, we are far, far from even understanding. So flow dreaming is a way to get you into this deeper layer of communication, of transformation, of direction. And when you're in there, I want you to communicate. This is where the final, most majestic piece happens. Communicating for us is a feeling. It's an emotion. And when I paint you pictures of things that you see or go look at this or feel that and you're happy and skipping along in your imagination, what I'm really saying to you is I'm giving you images that should make you feel things. If I show you a gorgeous waterfall of rampant abundance pouring down over you, pouring into your life with gold coins and diamonds and paper money, and you're surrounding in it, you're leaping in it, it's piling up. Yes, that's an image. But I don't want you to just see something without any connection to it. You could open a page of a book and look at a picture. I want you to feel it. I want you to become that, to know that sensation, to communicate it so it echoes back through the universes. This is what I feel. This is the energy of who I am. Do you see this? Do you feel this? I am telling you, I am shouting at you. I am joyfully singing at the top of my lungs. This is who I am. This energy is now inside me and part of me. You do this over and over. When you create something inside of you over and over, you become more of that thing. You go to the gym. You work your biceps every day. They get strong. Because why? You're impacting your body in a specific way over and over. You go into flow. You go into energy. You become more of what you are feeling. You become it in your cells, in your biology, in your neural networks. You become it in your spirit, in your heart, in your soul, in your energy being, your energy body. You want to be healthy? We feel health first. We feel buoyant and fabulous and ripe with energy and life and zest and everything working itself out and healing. You have to feel what healed feels like. Over and over. Now your body has no choice but to respond because you keep saying the same singular note over and over. We're healed. We're healed. Heal. We're healed. I'm helping you heal. I love you. What do you need? Heal. And can you see how everything starts to shift into the direction that you are pouring out? Flowdreaming, when you practice it the way I do, the way that thousands of people do, it becomes a daily ritual. It becomes something you do in the morning right after you write out your gratitude list or right after you do your meditation. It becomes something you do at night as you stand in the shower with your eyes closed and instead of ruminating about your day, you're having a discussion with all of you. This is what I am. This is who I should be. This is who I want to be. This is who I am becoming. And this is who I am. Watch, listen, feel with me as I show you. As a practice, it is intensely, intensely powerful. And I encourage you to bring it into your life. Now, I've already shared a couple of free resources with you, right? You can go to YouTube, watch Ignite Your Manifesting Power, learn about it, go back and listen to the Flow Dreaming, How to Flow Dream, the 101 episode here on the podcast. But the real way to go in deeper, come to my mastermind. Let's practice together live each month. I have 38 courses there that teach you all different ways to use this juicy and delicious, gorgeous inner power. And the mastermind is ongoing. You can join anytime, leave anytime. Go to flowdreaming.com and you'll see it there. The other thing that I highly, highly recommend, come have a session with me. Let's get this going right from the get-go. Let's get it going in a direction that makes sense to you, that reveals to you, this is where you need to go with this. This is what you need to be doing with it next. This is where it'll make the biggest impact in your life. If I do a private introductory session with you, it's part, honestly, psychic reading. It's part me being able to read and look at the important people in your life and read what they are thinking and feeling. I'm just reading information, folks. That's all I'm doing. But I want you to know, based on all the information that's out there, so you can make the best choice. It's partly deep energy activation work, because we will do a flow dream together, just you and me, custom, just for you, based on where you are in your life right now and what you need the most for the biggest bang for your buck, the biggest pivot, the biggest turning point for you. It's a combination of all of these things. It's a unique experience. And if you're curious, go to my website and look up private sessions, and maybe you'll even choose to work with me month after month for the biggest and most beautiful gains. Okay, enough said, but thank you for bearing with me because honestly, I don't have any ads in Flow Dreaming, this podcast. Maybe you've noticed by now. So everything, all the production is underwritten by my own shop, my own work. And that's why I thank you for listening as I share it with you. Plus, I'm just such a big believer. It's like, I can't not tell you about this. Okay, so we're going to go do instant alignment. And if you love this, I have this free for you at flowdreaming.com. You can go there and download it. I have another one there also called financial abundance, because those are, well, ones that everybody tends to respond to and love. Now, you're going to go in. You're going to do this with me. You are not going to experience meditation. My voice will not be quiet and soothing and make you not feel or just meditate out. You're going to feel. You're going to dive and leap. You're going to feel this kind of alignment, attunement with the universe, where everything in your life falls into place. Everything out of alignment snaps back into place where it should be, how it should be moving instead. And if this is your first taste, I really, really hope you love it. So without further ado, let's drop into instant alignment. Instant alignment, a flash flow dream. My eyes close, and I take a deep breath, counting to three as I inhale. And again, as I exhale.
begin to daydream. I daydream that I'm skating on an endless, solid lake of light. I feel myself glide, long, sweeping movements forward, perfectly balanced, feeling the breath of air against my cheeks, feeling a rush of energy and light surrounding me. I'm sweeping through the stars. I'm sweeping forward in perfect alignment with something powerful, potent, and strong. It's something luscious and gorgeous, something that feels so pure and good and right in every way. I feel this flow as a pull and a nudge and a sweep that's bringing me in toward my future. And I know, I can feel it. I'm on track. What I feel and create is happening here. Whatever I'm becoming, whatever my life is evolving and expanding into, is right here, originating here, in this perfect, beautiful alignment and field of energy and light. And so I feel this beautiful arc of light that is my flow that I'm so aligned to, sliding along. I feel how anything that's out of alignment is being nudged gently back in place. Going along with me now, everything coming back into smooth interaction and harmony in my life. I can sense this and see this around me like strands of light that became tangled. They're becoming untangled and now merging back into my flow, back into this beautiful arc. While other strands simply disengage, I let go of them in my flow, released. I only align to what is best for me. Whatever isn't mine or isn't good for me or isn't positive in my life is not aligned. Those things are for other people, not me. I allow my flow to move me. I let go. It's effortless and easy, and I'm surrounded right now by the percolating beginnings of new wonderful things. Things that are being seeded into my life like little geysers of light all around me. I also feel the rich, ripe fruits of those things that are already ready for me. Right there in my flow, I arc past them. I put out my hands to pick them, take them in, these shining fruits of opportunity, synchronicity, the right thing at the right time. I have everything I need before I ever need to ask. Good things come to me constantly. Oh, I'll take that, I say. Yes, please, yes, I'll take that. Thank you, thank you. I love this feeling of alignment and security and perfect direction. I sweep my arms across this space and I bring them back into my heart as I drink in this light all around me. Even now, as I pull back into my regular life, my regular consciousness, as I open my eyes, feeling absolutely realigned and wonderful.
Ah, so there you are. One of the things you probably noticed, which is characteristic of all Flowdream energy activations, is that even the music is not your typical meditation music. There's a bounce to it, a beat often. There's a buoyancy that's helping you kind of lift into that emotional space. Every time I record one of these, it's different imagery, different music, and frankly, a different focus. Like I said, there are hundreds you can choose from. If you don't have the app, go grab that now. It's on your phone. It also comes with a free tutorial. and or, again, the website. One final word, I look forward to hearing from some of you either as a new person showing up for a session. It is my hands down favorite thing to do with people. And or as part of the gorgeous mastermind where we can really start shaping and directing this energy every month. With that, lots of love. Have a beautiful and blessed day, and I'll see you for the next episode of Flowdreaming.
Maybe you remember one brilliant thing, my summertime manifesting challenge. Well, I wanted a way to keep that energy going all year round. That's how I ended up creating the Flowdreaming Mastermind. This is different than any other program I've offered. For one thing, it is packed with teachings. Not only do you get immediate access to 36 courses and all the accompanying Flowdreams and worksheets, but you and I will get to Flowdream together each month live. Each month, I plan a special event, a Flowdreaming session coinciding with the full moon or other potent day, and we gather to create huge manifesting energy. Think of it like a series of special events, and you're invited to every single one as a Flowdream Mastermind member, a flowy, if you will. And best of all, it's affordable. Costs as much as taking a family of four to Applebee's each month. No kidding. You'll get to connect with like-minded souls around the world for Flowdreaming parties, joyful energy cleansing, Flowdreaming, some woo-woo rituals that show a little of my witchy side, and just a heck of a good time. Because the lighter and brighter you are, the lighter and brighter your life is. Check out the Flowdreaming Mastermind at flowdreaming.com because our next special event and party is just around the corner.